हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल। आज की क्लास में हम पढ़ेंगे कल्टियस रीअरेंजमेंट रिएक्शंस, व्हिच इज द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट मेथड फॉर द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ एमाइन फ्रॉम एजाइड कंपाउंड और फ्रॉम एसिड क्लोराइड। मैं गंगरी सर आपका स्वागत करता हूं। लेट्स स्टार्ट कल्टियस रीअरेंजमेंट रिएक्शंस। नाउ सपोज वी हैव एसिड क्लोराइड। नाउ दिस एसिड क्लोराइड इज अलाउड टू रिएक्ट विथ This acid chloride is allowed to react with sodium azide, NaN3. When we heat, then sodium chloride will remove and we are getting a this type of structure, RC double bond O and here N3. Now, whatever the structure obtained, it is known as a acyl azide. This much part is acyl and this part is considered as an azide. Now, this acyl azide is unstable, so when we heat little it, then nitrogen gas will liberate, which is the one of the best living group. When nitrogen gas liberate, then we are getting an isocyanate. Now, whatever structure obtained, it is isocyanate will be obtained. Now, whatever isocyanate obtained to us, this isocyanate further undergo hydrolysis in the presence of water. When it undergo hydrolysis in the presence of water, carbon dioxide will remove and we will get primary amine. So it is observed that primary amine can be prepared from acyl chloride. So the basic concept you have to put in your mind that acyl chloride or acyl azide is converting in a primary amine, which has a one carbon atom less as compared to acid chloride. So we can write these things. What is the basic thing that By using this method, we can say that acid chloride or acyl azide. This acid chloride or acyl azide can be converted into primary amine. And this whatever primary amine obtained have a one carbon atom less. This is the basic thing of this reaction. Now, question will arise, how this acyl chloride is converting into azide, azide converting into isocyanate, and how we are getting primary amine. Then you should focus on mechanism. यदि आप mechanism जानते हो तो कोई भी questions, IIT का हो, JAN का हो, NEET का हो, you can solve very easily. So focus on this mechanism. Now, in a very first step, this acyl chloride, when allowed to react with acyl azide, then we get this azide structures. Now, whatever azide obtained, it has a this type of structure. When acyl chloride reacting with sodium azide, then we get acyl azide. Now, whatever acyl azide obtained to us, it has a resonating structure. So, we can write this structure in this way, RC double bond O, then this nitrogen having a double bonded with this nitrogen. Now, this nitrogen having a one valency less, so it has a one electron pair and negative charge. This nitrogen having a one valency more, so it has a positive charge and no electron pair. And this nitrogen having a three bond and one electron pair, so nothing charge on it. You know that nitrogen having a one non-bonding electron pair and three bond. So here you can observe that nitrogen with one electron pair and three bonds. This nitrogen having a one more bond, so it has a positive charge, no electron pair. This nitrogen having a one less bond as compared to three bond, so it has a negative charge and electron pair. Now this compound is unstable, so it has a resonance. And during this resonating structures, this nitrogen give electron pair to this nitrogen, and this bond will transfer on these structures. So we can write a structure in this way, RC double bond O. Now this nitrogen will give an electron pair to bond formations. So we can write these things. This nitrogen give electron pair to this nitrogen. So we can write this. Now this nitrogen having a triple bonds. So it has a triple bond. So it has only one electron pair. Now this nitrogen having a negative charge. This nitrogen having a positive charge because one bond is more. And now this nitrogen having a electron pair and negative charge. So now, it is observed that this is a totally resonating structure. This electron pair transfer to this nitrogen, so triple bond form between these nitrogens. So now, this electron pair, this electron pair transfer on this nitrogen. When transfer on nitrogen, nitrogen will get two non-bonding electron pair and negative charge. Now, it is observed that this is a totally unstable structure. So, in the first step of mechanism, in a step 1, when we hit these things, when we hit these structures, then on hitting of this structure, nitrogen will remove. Here, this bond will break. When this bond will break, nitrogen gas will remove. It is the best living group of world. Now, as a result, we will get this structure RC double bond O. Now, this nitrogen having this electron pair gone. So, nitrogen having no charge and two electron pair. And with this, we are getting a nitrogen gas. Now, whatever structure obtained, it is nothing but it is known as a nitrene. So, in a step 1, formation of nitrene occurs. We can write it in a step 1, formation of nitrene occur. Now, nitrene is unstable in nature. So, in step 2, nitrene will convert it into, isocyanate. So, we can write step 2, formation of isocyanate. Now, this for second step, formation of isocyanate. Now, this alkyl group, nitrogen having three bonds, but it is observed that here only one bond. So, this nitrogen give electron pair to carbon, then this bond will break, this alkyl with electron pair transfer on nitrogens. So, this nitrogen is unstable in nature, so it is converting in an isocyanate. This alkyl group with electron transfer on nitrogen. We can write structure in this way. Now double bond between carbon and nitrogen. Nitrogen will give an electron pair to carbon. So double bond between nitrogen and carbon. Alkyl group transfer on nitrogens. So whatever structure obtained, it is considered or known as an isocyanate. Now in the next step of mechanism, isocyanate undergo hydrolysis. Next step of mechanism is formation of carbamic acid. Now this isocyanate undergo hydrolysis and converting in a carbamic acid. We can write in this way R N double bond C double bond O. So here I will combine these two steps. In the presence of aqueous solutions, it is observed that this will disproportionate. Now this pi bond electron, here one sigma and second is pi bond. This pi bond electron will transfer on hydrogens. So now, here, this hydroxyl group attack on this carbon. When hydroxyl group attack on this carbon nitrogen bond will break. When this carbon nitrogen bond will break, this electron pair of pi bond will transfer on nitrogen. And nitrogen give electron pair to hydrogen. So now, we get this type of structure. This is a R, N, nitrogen having a hydrogens, and here carbon having a double bond with oxygen, and here hydroxyl group. So now whatever structure obtained to us, it is known as a carbamic acid. Okay, in Hoffman rearrangement reaction also we have studied in detail. यदि आपने मेरा वो वीडियो नहीं देखा तो देखिए, उसमें डिटेल से तीन स्टेप और है, उसमें मैंने डिटेल में बताया कि किस तरह से isocyanate का hydrolysis होता है. Now, in the same step, I will put this further. And here further, whatever hydroxyl group we have, this hydroxyl group, now, loss of carbon dioxide or decarboxylation of carbon, we can write the step 4, the decarboxylation of carbamic acid. Decarboxylation of carbamic acid, and as a result we will get a primary amine. Now here this hydroxyl group we have in a solution, so this hydroxyl group in aqueous solution will attack on hydrogen, it removes in the form of water. Now this electron pair transfer on oxygens, so this carbon oxygen double bond form, and here electron pair transfer on nitrogen. So we can write the structure in this way, that here R, N, H, here carbon having a double bond with oxygen, here oxygen with this hydrogen. Once again I would like to repeat, hydroxyl group attack on this hydrogen. So it will remove in the form of water molecule. Now, this mode electron transfer on oxygen, and oxygen give electron to carbon. This carbon or nitrogen bond will break and this electron will transfer on nitrogen. So we get this structure R nitrogen having a hydrogen with negative charge. And here carbon dioxide gas will release and with this we are getting a water molecule. Now in next step, this nitrogen give electron pair to water and we get a primary amine. Now in further in a next step, this water molecule I can write in this way, H and OH. Now nitrogen give electron pair to hydrogen, this electron pair transfer on oxygen. And as a result, we will get a primary amine. And with this we are getting a hydroxyl group. So now students, in this fourth step, SNZ is converting in a primary amine. And whatever primary amine obtained to us, it has a one carbon atom less. So, चलो एक बार रिवाइज कर लेते हैं किस तरह से हुआ. वेरी सिंपल थिंग, एसाइल क्लोराइड व्हेन रिएक्टिंग विद सोडियम एसाइड इट गिव्स एसाइल एसाइड. नाउ दिस एसाइल एसाइड हैज दिस टाइप ऑफ रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर्स. नाउ दिस सेंट्रल नाइट्रोजन हैविंग अ फोर बॉन्ड, दिस नाइट्रोजन हैविंग अ थ्री बॉन्ड. सो वन इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर, नाउ इट हैज अ फोर बॉन्ड, सो इलेक्ट्रॉन पेयर गिवन, सो पॉजिटिव चार्ज. दिस नाइट्रोजन हैविंग अ वन बॉन्ड लेस, सो इट इज अ नेगेटिव चार्ज. नाउ दिस इज द रेजोनेटिंग स्ट्रक्चर. Now when we hit this compound, then nitrogen gas will remove and it is converting in a nitrine. So in step 1, formation of nitrate will occur. Now whatever nitrine obtained to us, it is converting in a isocyanate. Nitrine is highly unstable. So nitrogen give electron pair to carbon, it is a 2 electron pair. So it form a bond with a carbon. At the same time, this bond will break, alkyl will transfer with electron on nitrogen. So as a result, we get this structure which is known as a isocyanate. Now this isocyanate undergo hydrolysis and form a carbamic acid. This structure R, NH, C, double OH is known as a carbamic acid. So we have aqueous solutions. In aqueous solutions, hydroxyl group of aqueous solution will attack on a carbon. So this pi bond will break. Now pi bond electron transfer on nitrogen. Nitrogen give electron pair to hydrogen. So we are getting that hydrogen attached with nitrogen and hydroxyl group attached with a carbon. And as a result we get carbamic acid. Now this carbamic acid undergo decarboxylations. This hydroxyl group attack on hydrogen, it remove in the form of water. Now this electron transfer on oxygen and oxygen give electron pair to carbon. So double bond will form between carbon and oxygen. At the same time this carbon nitrogen bond will break. Electron pair transfer on nitrogen, it is converting in a negatively charged species. Now carbon dioxide remove and we are getting a water molecules. Now this negatively charged species nucleophile will undergo protonation with a water and give primary amine. So now the basic funda of Curtius reaction or Curtius rearrangement reactions, we will get a primary amine from either acyl chloride or from acyl azide. But the most important thing, it has a one carbon atom less as compared to acyl azide or acyl chloride. Now we will study what are the different application of this Curtius rearrangement reaction. Now we start different applications of this Curtius rearrangement reaction. Suppose we are given a benzoyl chloride. So we want to obtain aniline from benzoyl chloride. So my next, suppose benzoyl chloride, then it is possible to convert into aniline. This is the structure of benzoyl chloride, you are knowing very well. This C double bond Cl here, then here C double bond O. Now this benzoyl chloride is allowed to react with the sodium azide and N3. So as a result, we will get this type of structure. Oxygen having a double bond with carbon and here we have a N3. Now whatever structure obtained, when we heat it further, nitrogen gas will remove and we get an isocyanate. So now structure of isocyanate, we can write in this way. This alkyl will transfer on So we can write this structure of isocyanate in this way, nitrogen having a double bond with carbon and carbon having a double bond with oxygen. So now, whatever isocyanate mechanism आप जानते हो, isocyanate whatever obtained to us, now further undergo hydrolysis reaction. So whatever structure obtained, it is undergo hydrolysis. So during this hydrolysis reaction, isocyanate will convert in carbon dioxide, will remove, hydrolysis will occur. When hydrolysis occur, we will get a aniline by use of this method. So here we have obtained aniline. So simple things, this is nothing but a benzoyl chloride. Now benzoyl chloride on reaction with a sodium azide, so we get azide of benzoyl chloride, which on further heating, this nitrogen is the best leaving group, it will remove. So we get isocyanate of benzoyl chloride and isocyanate of benzoyl chloride on hydrolysis. You know very well now mechanism, you are knowing very well. So is tarah se ye CO will remove in the form of carbon dioxide and we get a nitrogen will convert into NH2. So we get a aniline. So aap dekh sakte ho ki as compared to benzoyl chloride, aniline having a one carbon atom less. So this is the concept that we are getting primary amine with one carbon atom less. उसी तरह से सपोज आपको यह स्ट्रक्चर दिया गया है. नाउ यू हैव टू, आई एम नॉट गिविंग डायरेक्ट नेम, बट यू हैव टू डिसाइड व्हाट विल बी द प्रोडक्ट. सपोज आई हैव गिवन अ दिस टाइप ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर CH3 CH2 एंड C डबल बॉन्ड O Cl. सो दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज नोन एज अ प्रोपेनॉइल क्लोराइड. नाउ प्रोपेनॉइल क्लोराइड इज गिवन टू अस. Now this propanoyl chloride, one by one, on Curtius rearrangement reaction, what will happen? The CO will remove and NH2 will enter. How this we will study that? It allowed to react with azide, NaNO3. When it reacting with the azide, we are getting this type of structure, CH3, CH2, here, CO. Or we can write this oxygen having a double bond and here, nitrogen, N3. Now which is further on heating, this will be heated further, so nitrogen gas will liberate, and when nitrogen gas liberate, we are getting a isocyanate. So isocyanate having this type of structure CH3CH2, then after it is attached with a nitrogen, and nitrogen having a double bond with carbon and carbon having a double bond with a oxygen. So this we are obtain a isocyanate. Now whatever isocyanate obtained to us, it undergo further hydrolysis in the presence of moisture. So when undergo hydrolysis in the presence of moisture, this carbon dioxide, it will remove in the form of carbon dioxide, and then this nitrogen will convert into amine. So as a result, CH3, CH2 and H2, we have obtained a primary amine. And name of this primary amine, we can give ethanamine. So now whatever ethanamine obtained, it has a one carbon atom less. Here propanoyl chloride having a three carbon atom, it has a one carbon atom. So now directly you can write this different type of product. Suppose some direct application I would like to give you. Now you have to decide what will be the product. Ab hum step nahi follow karenge. Aapko directly hi batana hoga ki what will be the product. Suppose I have taken this type of benzoyl chloride. Suppose I have taken this type of benzoyl chloride. Then what will be product on Curtius rearrangement reaction? Just I am writing all together NN3, then after hydrolysis what will be obtained product? Then this CO will remove, and as a result this COCl group will remove, and in a place of this NH2 will come. So we will get this type of structure, we will get this structure that it has a NH2, and name of this structure is benzene 1,4-diamine. So we get this benzene 1,4-diamine by use of this reaction. So variety of product, this directly simple concept should be in your mind, kis tarah se conversion hota hai. Now one more applications, one more. Suppose you have given this type of any structure, here you have given a COCl, you have given a COCl, and here given a CH3. Then on Curtius rearrangement reactions, we have a NaN3, and then after we have given a hydrolysis. NaN3 and we have hydrolysis, then you can decide that the COCl will convert into NH2. So whatever structure obtained, we can write NH2CH3. So this structure is 4-amino toluene, it is known as a toluidine, or we can write it is nothing but a para toluidine. So this para toluidine will be obtained on Curtius rearrangement reactions. Now an exceptional example of this. Now you assume that we have this type of azide structure. We have this type of azide structure COC double K, and here we have a N3. So this is one type of azide structure is given to us directly. Now it undergo further reactions. Just written that it is undergoing hydrolysis in the presence of alkali. In alkaline medium it undergo hydrolysis. First it is heated in the presence, then after hydrolysis reactions. Then what will be obtained? When we heat this thing, azide nitrogen will remove. Azide nitrogen will remove, so it will converting in a this type of isocyanate structure. We can write here COK, and we are getting this type of isocyanate structure and double bond C, double bond O. Now further, this on hydrolysis part, when it undergo hydrolysis in the presence of base, suppose we have given this type of azide. Here we are doing hydrolysis. When hydrolysis is done by us, this will remove in the form of carbon dioxide, and as a result we will get this type of structure. Here also hydrolysis occurs, so we get this type of structure COOH, and here NH2. Here we have a COOH and here we have a NH2. Okay, now application number third. Okay, now application number five. We have given this type of structure of azide. We have given this type of structure COOK and here N3. So this is one type of azide. Now azide on heating, when we heat this azide, this is converting in an isocyanate. Now you are knowing mechanism very well. Mechanism pata ho, tabhi aap ye sab kar paoge. You can solve this if you know mechanism very well. Now further undergo hydrolysis. Now when on hydrolysis, here when we have heated, nitrogen gas is liberated. Now on hydrolysis, this much part will remove in the form of carbon dioxide gas, and this will converting in a NH2. Now this carbon having a hydrogen already. So now whatever product obtained, structure we can write RCH2 here. This nitrogen is converting in NH2 and here COOH. So whatever structure obtained, it is known as amino acid. So it is observed that an alkyl amino acid or amino acid is possible to prepare from azide compound. Suppose as a R here nothing but hydrogen, as R here nothing but hydrogen, then we are getting the structure will be a glycine. So this is the one of the most important application. And last, we have given this type of simple structure of azide compound. Whatever azide, we have this type of simple azide compound. Now this azide we are heating, then this nitrogen gas will remove and we are getting a isocyanate. In isocyanate, we have this type of structure and double bond C, double bond O. Now, suppose if this isocyanate, instead of water, hydrolysis occur in the presence of alcohol, ROH, R-OH, then reaction product will be different. Then reaction product will be different. Reaction occur in this way. Mechanism you are knowing very well. This bond will, pi bond will break. Pi bond will break, pi bond electron transfer on nitrogen, this electrophile, this bond will break, this nitrogen give electron pair to hydrogen. This will attack on carbon, when this part attack on nucleophile strong, attack on carbon, then this pi bond break, pi bond electron transfer on nitrogen, nitrogen give electron pair to hydrogen. So as a result we will get this type of structure, here R, N, H. And here C double O R dash, you will get C double O R dash. So now, whatever structure obtained to us, it is known as a urethane. So we can obtain urethane by using this method. Whatever structure obtained to us, it is known as urethane. Name of this product will be urethane. So once again, suppose this is a azide compound. Now little new thing, azide compound on heating, we are getting an isocyanate. We have obtained this isocyanate. Now whatever isocyanate obtained to us, it undergo hydrolysis. Hydrogen transfer on nitrogen and OR will attach with a carbon, this pi bond breaks. So as a result, we are getting RNHCOOR. If hydrolysis is done in the presence of alcohol, if you are doing hydrolysis in the presence of water, then we are getting NH2 here. But instead of water, if we have taken alcohol, then we are getting urethane by using this method. So now, students, आपको मेरा lecture कैसा लगा? पसंद आया? तो like करें, share करें और subscribe करें.